Hey everyone, yesterday I received my Ubiquiti 10 gigabit networking switch, which is great because that's a key part of my plan to move all my media content off my workstation PC and onto my Homelab NAS that I built recently in another video. I can then do all my video editing, which is 4K, over the network on my workstation PC and my laptop. However, at the moment my Ubiquiti switch is just running in unmanaged or dumb mode. So what I've done so far, I've plugged it in with power over Ethernet because I've got a MercuSys power over Ethernet switch down there. And then I plugged in my Homelab NAS, which has a 10 gigabit networking card, and I also plugged in my workstation PC. Now right now, the workstation PC doesn't have the networking card because the motherboard doesn't really fit it, unfortunately. So right now this is limited to 2.5 gig speeds off the motherboard, but that's still better than nothing and is still speeding things up by quite a lot. But in order to actually get a managed network switch online with Ubiquiti, you can't just go to the web console like you could with many other managed switches. What you've got to do instead is download some software and then provision the management features of the switch. So in this video, what I'm going to be doing is actually installing the UniFi Network server control software. They changed the name, but it's called something like that. I'm going to install it on my Homelab NAS, which is running Debian, and then hopefully I can actually access the management portal of my network switch on here and get a bit more information than just, you know, having a dumb switch floating around doing nothing. So in terms of actually installing the network server software, there is actually somebody called Glenn who has created this massive script that does everything you need to know. And that is brilliant, but in general, I'm always a bit scared of installation scripts and just running them on my home network. If I don't know what they're doing, I don't really just want to run them. I'm sure the software works well, but I'm going to try installing the network server self-hosted without any scripts or anything like that. So let's just see how we go. So the first things I need to do is install some packages. Fine, that should be easy enough. Yes, I want to continue. That's fine. That's an easy step, and it's good to install all the SSL stuff. So now I need to actually add a new package. I can see that comes from ubiquiti.ui.com, so that should be absolutely fine. Yep, so that's it. So that's just adding that for Debian, which is brilliant. Add the keys. That's also come in from UI.com, so that should be fine. As I said, I'm a little bit more paranoid than some people would be. I know some people are happy just to run a script, but I tend to just check things in a bit more detail. So running that should be okay as well. So that's installed. So we need to install MongoDB, which is fair enough as well. Wget, so we're also going to install that. That's fine. Echo, Debian, we go add that to the sources list. Should be fine. No issue why not. Again, it's MongoDB. And then they want to make sure that's up to date. Sudo. No, that's not how you do it. Oh, the following signature was invalid. Well, that's a good start, isn't it? Let's just Google that error. Release, blah, 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 blah. Mongo not update on that. Brilliant. This is probably because it's out of date, isn't it? Okay, I'm just going to switch to root to try and fix this error. So apt key, delete, and then I need to delete that key. Would it be that? Yes, okay. So that's deleting that. Now, this is actually installing a newer version of Mongo, but that could make sense, to be honest. Yeah. So apt date. No. Couldn't be verified because the public key is not available. This is a good start, isn't it? Okay, following signatures couldn't... So that's probably based on my actual list of sources, I'm supposing. Let's have a look. Because if I've put 4.4, I'd probably need the 4.4 source, don't I? So let's delete that then. Let's delete that and get... Hang on. Debian, MongoDB... Okay, there's actually a specific guide for this on the Mongo website for Debian, so I should probably check that first. MongoDB is not maintained by Mongo and it conflicts with the official one, but I don't think I've got anything, am I? MongoDB, no, I don't think I do. Okay, so I have to install those. Asking me. Yes. Surprised I didn't have curl already, but there we are. That's okay. So next we are gonna... Next we're gonna do that. To download that, brilliant. And now I need to check the actual file itself. So let me move, I may as well just remove this. So remove that, and then touch add. Okay, great. So if I actually look at that Mongo file now, I have that, which should be the latest. So now, apt date. Haha, right, so I was just looking at the one guide. That's okay. Can be updated, fine. So update, firstly, apt upgrade. So I'm firstly going to do that just to have clean slate, and then I can install Mongo. So LibreOffice, Python, yeah, fine. Fine. So as you're running, it's just going to be that, isn't it? Apt install Mongo. Do I need any of the optional stuff? Let's have a look. No. No, I shouldn't. Okay, so just gotta wait for this to run. The actual install instructions take you to some random place which don't give you much information on them, just telling you to download a phone app, but the phone app doesn't work because you need the Ubiquiti Network controller, and then when you look at the documentation for that, it doesn't actually work because the actual instructions they're giving are like almost 10 years out of date, so that's good. I wonder when Mongo was actually released. MongoDB 3.8 release date. When did it actually come out? Let's have a look. So that's what they're telling me to get, is 3.6, sorry, that's even older. So when did 3.6 come out? It came out in 2017, yeah, so those install instructions are really out of date. But I'm hoping 7.0 will, it should be able to be installed fine once this apt upgrade finishes. I'm hoping then that Ubiquiti software works with it as well. It looks like it based on the other script, so we're on Glenn's script, so let's just have a look. Right, anyway, so that's all updated, so now let's install Mongo. You see there it's installed in 7.0, so fingers crossed, that should all work fine. Great, okay. And then, in theory, I can install UniFi. So in theory, this is the last step, and then I should be able to have managed features on my network switch, but let's have a look. Preparing, please don't give me any errors. Please don't give me errors. Okay, so it's unpacking Qala, bin utils, Java version 17, fine. And this is the big one then. So UniFi, the package is coming in, it's being unpacked. So this is version 8.3.32. Okay, so UniFi is being set up. It's also added a boatload of trusted keys, which is fine, with certificate authorities. It's creating a symlink. So in my other tab, I'm just going to see if UniFi is running yet. What would it be, Uni? So it's a Java application, which, yeah, it looks like it. It's running one of the UniFi things, and Mongo is running as well. So that's good. Yes. Brilliant. Okay, so that's finished. Now, it doesn't give me any more information than that, but it looks like it's running there. In theory, what I can now do is, because it's installed as a service, so I could just do UniFi status, and it's saying it's running. If for whatever reason I didn't want it running, I could just stop it. And it's a bit slow, but if I look in my other tab, it's now not running, so that's not running. And if I come along and click start, it should also work. Yes, it looks like it started. Brilliant. Okay, so that's good. So the UniFi network application should now be accessible at the computer's configured IP address. I don't actually know. Right, okay, I wouldn't be going, I was going to say I don't know the IP address of my network switch, although I could find it on my Evo app, but it's actually the IP address of my Debian server, which makes sense because that's where everything's running. Okay, let's have a look then. So, the port, are you going to tell me the port, or should I just guess? No. Ugh, fine. Ubiquiti network controller default. Port. Let's just do it like that. 8443. Okay. Ah, okay. That's now worked. Right, so 8443. My understanding is that the script doesn't tend to run as root, so as a result, instead of running on 443, which would be the default SSL port, you can't actually run like that if the port is below 1024 and it's not running as root. So that's why I think they've just gone for the port 8443, because that's like the alternate one for non-root users. Okay, so I can ignore that certificate. Oh, look at this! Yeah, fine. My country, that's the smallest drop-down box I've ever seen. My country will be the United Kingdom. I agree, I have to agree. But clearly I've read all those agreements offline. Next. Sign into my account. setting up the server. Look at that. Okay, so I've got a self-hosted Ubiquiti network. At this point, I'm going to go into full screen. So, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Why do I get nothing? Server uptime, 6 minutes. Topology. Yes, okay, there's my flex. Adopt, that's it. I read somewhere you need to actually adopt a device. Adopt. It's updating. Okay, so that took absolutely ages. Basically, I finished updating and then the network died, as you'd probably expect, because the network switch started rebooting as part of the firmware update. So I'm hoping if I press this reload button... Haha, look at that. I got a network topology. So that's my switch. This is my study PC that I'm logged into, and then obviously my Homelab NAS, which run in Debian. So that is connected over 10 gigabit Ethernet. You can see that at the moment. It's only got 3 minutes of uptime because of the network switch updating. And then the study PC is currently 2.5 gig. And again, not much uptime at the moment. You can see insights and stuff, but obviously right now it's not going to do much. But in general, that is all set up. There's not much to see right now, and in a future video what I'm actually going to be doing is poking through this dashboard in a lot more detail, but right now you can see I have actually installed the UniFi Network controller, and the way I done it was with the self-hosted method instead of using Glenn's really awesome script. And I'm sure the Glenn script would work absolutely well, I think most people use it, but my only concern with it is it's such a long script, and unless I understand what script's going to do, I'm not really willing to run a script like that route in my home network. But that's no disrespect to Glenn or anything like that. I much prefer to say, right, let's install Mongo 7.0 in this case, not 3.6, and then let's install UniFi directly from the source. And I can see the sources are from UI.com, Ubiquiti, and also the Mongo.org website. You can see that's all there. Brilliant. So I got the switch there, and if you look at a bit more detail, you can see it's actually laid out how everything's connected. So I've got my uplink, which is currently coming from a PoE switch, so it's giving gigabit networking. Yeah, you can see green, so gigabit there. I've then got 10 gigabit port, which is in use, which will be my Homelab NAS. And then the other one is a slightly lighter shade of blue for 2.5 gig. The benefit of having this is I can actually see exactly what's happening. So if suddenly my workstation PC drops down to 100 meg networking, I can actually come in here and get a bit more information about it. And that wraps up this video. I'm glad to actually get this all set up and I can see my networking in a lot more detail. I've only got 2 devices there right now, but in time I'll have more. But thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful or enjoyable. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.